This is Manjusha Radhakrishnan from Gulf News, and I'm here with the review of Bulbul. It's produced by Clean Slate Films, which is co-owned by Anushka Sharma and directed by Anvita Dutt. Now, this is one of the rare films where there's Indian mythology, folklore, and supernatural elements woven into one. In fact, it's the cinematic equivalent of a beautiful painting. The cinematography is superb. And it also draws you into this world set in the 19th century Bengal. There is Tripti Dimri, who had my heart. She is the child bride who grows into an adult. And you have to see the way she, sinks her teeth into this role. I mean, she plays this role with such wickedness and wantonness. It's quite interesting and intriguing to see her. She's quite empowered. And one of her friends, I mean, this movie oscillates between her past and her present. She makes a friend in her husband's brother. Husband is much older, looks more like a father figure. And then there is the husband's brother, Satya, played by Avinash Tiwari, and who becomes her best mate. It's almost like Devdas, but with a more horrific twist. They become best friends, but when he goes to London, her entire world comes crashing down. And how her husband takes to it. There's also Shakespearean Othello twist to it, where you feel almost like Rahul Bose plays Thakur, but he's so consumed by jealousy and pettiness, and he's so swayed by what everybody around is telling about his young wife, the insecurity. He's almost like the captain in Othello. So he was very interesting, and there is something very dark and twisted about this film, and that's what I enjoyed the most. Although you see the twists and the turns that are coming a half mile away, what really sets this movie apart is the haunting music score. The background score by Amit Trivedi adds the atmospherics. It's almost like it draws you into that world. For that 1.5 hours, you are transported into a world where there are fairies, there are witches, and there's evil lurking around the corner. And also, it's one of the rare movies where, you know, patriarchy and the violence against women is shown. It's shown in a very crude manner towards the end, but at the same time, it hits home. They don't try to make it a sob story. Women in this film are very, very interesting. Both Tripti's character and Pauli Dam's character, who plays the evil sister-in-law, a scheming one. You can see the dynamics between them, the power games that they play. It's very, very interesting. And the chemistry between Tripti and Rahul Bose, who acts as this tyrannical husband towards the end, as this landlord, the feudal lord, and who's very patriarchal, is also, he's a complex character. It's very easy to hate him, yet you seem to understand him, and that is one of the biggest success of this film. Every character has a good backstory. And then, of course, there's Paramrita Chatterjee. I can't say how he's like the breath of fresh air in a movie filled with dark and twisted characters. There is this Paramrita actor with he's very sweet faced, and he's like the nice, the good hearted, gentle force in this movie, and he compliments the other characters quite well. I really enjoyed this film. There will be times when towards the end it becomes a bit dramatic, but if you're invested in this movie, you're likely to enjoy it, because how many times can you boast of a time when a movie reminds you of a beautiful painting and also your grandmother's tale? It's got both soul and spirit. I am going with 3.5 out of 5. For my full review, go to gulfnews.com/tabloid.